PC World fans, Gordon Ung here, checking out Lenovo's new ThinkBook 16P Gen 3. Yes, I know you can buy it already. Why am I covering this? Well, because you love your Ryzen laptops, and this is a Ryzen laptop. It is basically, in the language of Hollywood and the only thing people can understand, Lenovo's XPS 15 killer. It gives you premium metallic lid, metal bottom, metal keyboard deck. It breathes basically a content creator's laptop. Not necessarily a gaming laptop, even though it will do it. This is basically aimed at people who want to do video editing, photo editing, and all the kind of things who want a premium experience and also a lot of graphics. Inside, of course, is AMD's new Ryzen 6000 CPUs up to a Ryzen 9. This particular one has a Ryzen 7 in it. That, of course, is an 8-core, 16-thread CPU, really power-efficient, good stuff. For graphics, you get AMD's integrated graphics on that Ryzen 6000 and GeForce RTX 3060. In this particular one, tuned up to a nice, toasty 90 watts of power. So you're gonna get a lot of performance in a very thin laptop. Let's do the ports, because you wanna hear about ports on laptops. Internet loves it, I know you do. On this side, we get a SD card reader, a combo headset jack. Thank you, Lenovo, for doing that. On back, this is not a USB port. This is Lenovo's square charger. A proprietary, yes, but you can get these things all day, very cheap, and people typically have a million of them if they have Lenovo laptops, and it delivers more power than you can do mostly with a traditional USB-C, unless it's the newest thing. Full-size HDMI, you're getting a properly labeled USB 3.2 10 gig with a charging out port, as well as a second USB 3.2 type A 10 gig. On this side, of course, is a lock port and two USB-C ports. One is USB 3.2 Gen 2, that basically means 10 gigs, and the other one is USB 4. And as I understand it, the implementation here is what we expect. It will have Thunderbolt compatibility, PCIe, all that good stuff that you're expecting out of USB 4. The keyboard itself is a very decent rubber dome keyboard that we come to expect. You get your 10 key with the properly placed zero, decent trackpad. You will get up to 32 gigs of LPDDR5. That basically means it's soldered on, because LPDDR5 can only be soldered on. That's a good thing if you want power efficiency rather than upgradability. For wireless, you get Wi-Fi 6E, Bluetooth 5.1, a 71 watt hour battery, and the panel is a 165 hertz 16-inch 2.5K IPS, rated at up to 500 nits with the X-Rite Pantone certified from the factory, because again, this is intended as a content creator's laptop, and looks like it'll be very capable of it, and I think this will probably give an XPS 15 a really good run for its money. Not everybody wants a Windows-based big screen laptop, and for those folks, Lenovo has the IdeaPad 5i Chromebook 16. As its name implies, it's got a 16-inch panel, and Lenovo says this is technically the largest screen you can get on a Chromebook. There have been some 15.6-inch laptops, but since this is a 16-inch 16:10 aspect ratio screen, it's actually quite a bit bigger than a 15.6-inch laptops that you've seen before. Resolution is up to a 2.5K 350-nit panel. So for a Chromebook, that is a lot of screen real estate. Inside this Chromebook, you're gonna get up to a 12th Gen Core i3 Alder Lake, up to 8 gigs of LPDDR4X. And for storage, you'll get up to a 512 gig SSD, or for lower cost versions, up to a 128 gig eMMC drive, which is gonna be considerably slower, but for most Chromebook users, not gonna make that much of a difference. Wireless, though, is very advanced. You're getting a 2x2 Wi-Fi 6E Wi-Fi, Bluetooth 5, and there are actually two-watt speakers. The camera is also actually better than most laptops out there at a 1080p resolution screen for your video conferencing. Let's do the ports, because I know you love the ports, internet. You want to talk about the ports. On this side, we get a lock port, a USB-C port, a Type A, obviously, and on the other side, we get a second Type C. It does charge only over USB-C, which is great. A second Type A, so for your keyboard and mouse, good stuff. A headset jack, thank you, Lenovo, and micro SD card if you want to add a little more storage by just putting the card in there all the time. Last spec I'm going to mention is the weight. At 4.1 pounds, it's not exactly super light. It does have a plastic shell all around, but feels fairly solid. I think the main reason you'd want this is you got eyes that aren't great and you want just bigger things. So I appreciate the bigger screen myself. And for most Chrome OS users, you're not looking at super high performance and all that stuff. You just want a big screen. Come back to PC World's channel for more coverage of in-depth PC and laptop related topics, and also visit PCWorld.com for daily news that you need.